series Living Positively being organized by DAV Public School Sector 49 Gurugram. Now, I, Pooja Yadav, Supervisory Head of the school, take this privilege of introducing the viewers to our panelists. We have with us Dr. Shubhang Singh. Good evening, Dr. Sir.
Good evening, ma'am.
Department of Internal Medicine, Medanta. Sir has formerly been the CSR Medanta and is also the project lead for public health initiatives. Dr. Shubhang is also the president of Indo-Nepal Doctors Association India and vice president Indo-Nepal Association for Peripheral Nerve Surgery and Lymphology. Sir is also the founder president Indo-Afghanistan Friendship Association. Working for the training of the youth, sir has trained more than 150,000 school students in 6 steps of hand hygiene training and has also worked in various urban slum of Delhi NCR. Dr. Shubhang has served as a lead project on Mission Stop Dengue launched by Padam Shri Dr. Naresh Prihan, CMG Medanta. I will say only this out of a big list of projects sir is working upon. We welcome you, Dr. Shubhang, and thank you for taking up
this
time from your super busy schedule. We also have with us Dr. Meenakshi. Dr. Meenakshi Kanju is MD Community Medicine and is presently working with DAV Public School Sector 49 Gurugram. Ma'am is also an ex-associate consultant at Medanta Gurugram and also at Narayana Rudalia, Bangalore. We welcome you, ma'am. Let me also introduce our viewers to Ms. Manju, the yoga faculty from our school, to throw more light on the simple basic exercises to boost up our immunity. We also have with us the principal of our school, Ma'am Charumeni, the moderator for the session. And I should share with all that this webinar series is a seed of ma'am's thoughts. And through this platform, we are blossoming her dream to benefit all our dear viewers. So here we are. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Pooja, for such wonderful introduction. And once again, I would like to welcome Dr. Shubhang. Such a busy schedule and so many patients calling you day and night, and you are attending to all of them, and still you have got time for us. Thanks a lot. And this just shows that how dedicated you are to your mission to have a disease-free India. So thank you so much. And I also thank Dr. Meenakshi. We had our session on Living Positively earlier also, and where we had doctors from Medanta, where we were talking about how to stay in the healthy in these COVID times and what are the various precautions, etc. At that time, my dear viewers, few of the questions went unanswered because there were too many queries. We had 4,000 views. It was an overwhelming response. And I wish that this time also, each one of you who's watching us gains from this webinar so that we keep on adding to our knowledge base. I would just add, we all who are staying in this era are going to be a part of history, my dear viewers, because the BC and AC, they are going to have new connotations before Corona and after Corona. And we are going to be the generation who have seen both the before Corona era and after Corona era. That's what people are saying, that this is here to stay. Let's see what things are there in store for us. So if we have to stay with this Corona, so how do we go about it? How do we prevent ourselves from catching the infection? Or if we have the infection, then how to brave through it so that we survive through it? Because they say survival of the fittest. So the doctors here and the yoga specialists would say that. And do we have Dr. Meenakshi? Dr. Meenakshi, Dr. Shubhang, please tell us how do we prevent ourselves from this disease? Because now we are talking about unlocking ourselves, and everyone is on the roads and working. So what are the precautions and how to go about it? Okay, Dr. Shubhang.
Good evening, everyone. Namaskar. Corona namaste. Jaisa ki aap sabhi jante hain, कि वी आर इन दिस न्यू एरा वेयर यू नो shaking hands, hugging each other, or, you know, going very close is not permitted because of COVID infection. So what we are doing, we all are doing namaste. You could do even adab or hi, so that at least you don't go very near to a person. Neither you get infection nor you infect him, because usually this virus lies in the nasopharynx. And if you take small precautions, you can save millions of lives. So as very rightly Principal Ma'am has said, that importance of health is realized when it is lost. Hindi mein, swasth ki mehatta tabhi pata chalti hai jab hum bimar hote hain. Jab hum swasth hote hain, hume koi lena dena nahi hota ki swasth kya hai ya nahi hai. So I am very thankful to DAV group of institutions, especially to Charu Ma'am, Dr. Meenakshi, and everyone in the team, for organizing a session on thinking positively and building up your immune system and how to stay healthy, especially during this COVID time. As we all know, the definition of health by World Health Organization is the complete well-being of physical, mental, social, spiritual well-being, not merely an absence of disease, which leads to socially and economically productive life. So you should economically do something, and socially also you should be active. You shouldn't go and meet your relatives, or you shouldn't invite guests, but socially, maybe through video conferencing, you should interact with each other so that you don't feel depressed.
Very rightly said, Dr. Shubham. Nowadays, people are resorting to these video conferencing for various, even marriage functions are being held. And for us at DAV, people are even holding the yagnas also virtually. So all these are the new techniques that people are resorting to. So Dr. Shubham, how to prevent? What is immunity and how to prevent ourselves? That is what I would like to
find. So corona. Yeah. So whenever we have a terrorist attack, just to make it very simple, whenever we have, from outside invaders coming to our country, we may call them terrorists or we may call them enemy. In the same way, certain types of protein in the form of virus, they come from the outside, outside of our body. And for our body, they are terrorists. So our body attacks, our body produces soldiers, the way we, deploy our soldiers on the international borders. In the same way, our body produces antibodies. So this is known as the immune response. Against any antigen, against any odd protein, anyone who is terrorist to our body, who is unknown to our body produces certain soldier cells, because our body wants to protect different organ system. So this is, in simple lay language, I can define is the immune system, immune response, and how we can protect, especially about COVID infection. I'll just talk about 10 simple points. Sirf 10 cheeze batani hai mujhe jo bahut zaruri hai aur wahi hame apni pocket mein lekar jani hai, which is the take home message. Sabse important kya hai? Wo hai, agar zaruri nahi hai to bahar nahi jana. Only and only if it is very essential, you go out. Second thing, use mask. Without mask, you are not permitted to go outside. Third thing, social distancing. If you are going out for your grocery, if you are going out to buy milk or for vegetables, anything, you should always maintain social distance. Because if a person coughs or sneezes in front of you, that virus stays there, maybe in air for a few hours. And if you go very close to him, you can catch that virus. So social distancing, how much? Minimum 6 to 8 feet. That should always be maintained. Then regular hand sanitization. So you should wash your hands repeatedly. The best way is soap and water. However, it's not always available with us, because when we are out, we are working, we are on our job. So we can carry a sanitizer, and it should be minimum 70% of alcohol sanitizer. Otherwise, soap and water, if you have access of soap and water, that is the best. Next important thing is, if you have coughing or sneezing, then this is the cough etiquette. This is the sneezing etiquette. You can't cough in your hand. So that's a bad habit most of us have. Or if you are using a hanky, then you are infecting your pocket. But it should be then personal hanky. It shouldn't be used by anyone. It should be the personal towel. It shouldn't be used by anyone. or the disposable tissues. That should be properly disposed. You can't come back home, throw your mask anywhere or your tissues anywhere, and then you will infect your parents and grandparents. So that's bad. So what you have to do, if you are out coughing and sneezing like this, because virus goes here. When one coughs or sneezes, millions of copies of virus comes out. So this part is infected, not your hands. So at least you are not giving infection to anyone. Sixth point is, don't touch your nose, mouth, and this area. This is the danger area of your face. Why, students? I'm very sure many students and their parents, they are watching this session. क्यों ये सबसे खतरनाक है? ये danger area है हमारे शरीर का, क्योंकि सारी nerve endings यहाँ पर होती हैं जो सीधा brain से connect होती हैं. तो आप यहाँ पर जितना ज्यादा touch करेंगे, जितना infection होगा, brain तक जा सकता है, पहली बात. दूसरी बात, कोरोना के टाइम में कोरोना वायरस स्किन पे कम रहता है, वो आप वॉश कर सकते हैं, क्लीन कर सकते हैं नोज के म्यूकस मेम्ब्रेन में, और माउथ में अंदर वहां ज्यादा रहता है, या आईज में. सो या तो यू वियर ग्लासेस और प्रोटेक्ट योर आईज, डोंट रब इट, डोंट टच योर नोज रिपीटेडली, एंड नो फिंगर इन योर माउथ, नेवर. सो इफ यू प्रैक्टिस दिस एटलीस्ट फ्रॉम हैंड्स, यू आर नॉट ब्रिंगिंग दिस वायरस इन. नेक्स्ट थिंग इज, व्हेन यू कम टू योर हाउस फ्रॉम आउटसाइड, obviously remove your shoes outside. Don't bring your outside shoes inside your house, because you are bringing any type of bacteria, virus, fungus, whatever. Leave that outside. Wash your feet, wash your hands, then come inside. Always and always sanitize your car accessories, your cards, your grocery bag, your any bag which you are carrying, you know, your wallet, accessories like your goggles, maybe you know, jewelry or hairpin. All these items are very necessary, because if you don't sanitize them properly, you are bringing infection, or you leave them outside your house, whichever is your daily bag, etc. Next important thing, which is very, very important to prevent, is washing of grocery and washing of milk packets. So first request is, don't buy raw milk, because during this time, you don't know whether, you know, which kind of infection is coming in that particular raw milk. So always buy the packet milk, that is pasteurized milk, so that chances of any type of bacteria in it, virus in it, is very less. And wash the packets properly, either with, you know, soap water solution, or you could use some disinfectant spray, or just wash it with any ordinary detergent. Leave it for a few minutes, let it air dry, and then keep it in your refrigerator. You can buy 4 or 5 packets, I mean, all together, and then use it slowly and replace it with milk powder also, so that consumption is less. 10th important point, which is most important, is washing of vegetables. So if you are bringing fresh vegetables, just wash them under you know, running tap water, let it be air dry, or you can use normal saline water, that is, add salt in the water and then you can wash it and let it be naturally dry, or you can use the bleaching powder. Any of the way you can use, all these are the approved ways. It's not necessary to use any soap water or any particular disinfectant to clean your vegetables and fruits. And try to take properly cooked vegetables only. The Indian style of cooking is very healthy, very scientific. We cook vegetables very nicely over 10 minutes. So no bacteria, no virus can survive. Avoid raw vegetables and fruits at least for 1 month, till we have so many cases. Or if you are eating fruits, if you are very fond of eating fruits, then peel it off. Wash it properly, peel it off, and then consume. These 10 easy steps. There is no rocket science. 10 very easy steps. If you follow, you can prevent this disease, because the whole strategy about this disease is only 3 alphabets, that is CAP. Knowledge, attitude, and practice. Aapko iske bare mein knowledge hai kya? Aapne itni sari YouTube videos dekh li. इतना फेसबुक पे देखा, इतना न्यूज में आया, इतना न्यूज़पेपर में आ चुका. यू ऑलरेडी हैव सो मच ऑफ नॉलेज, प्रोबेबली यू नो मोर देन मी, बट डू यू हैव योर एटीट्यूड टू चेंज इट? सम पीपल डोंट. वो कहते हैं कि नहीं वॉश करेंगे हैंड यार, हम कहीं बाहर ही नहीं गए, वी विल नॉट यूज सोप एंड वाटर, क्यों करें अननेसेसरी, वी हैव नॉट टच्ड एनी कंटेमिनेटेड सर्फेस. एंड देन टू ब्रिंग इट इन प्रैक्टिस, यू हैव अ एटीट्यूड, यू वॉन्ट टू सेव योर सेल्फ, बट इफ यू आर नॉट प्रैक्टिसिंग इट रेगुलरली, देन इट्स बैड. यू हैव टू प्रैक्टिस. And if you follow this CAP rule, I'm sure all of you will be safe, your family will be safe, your community will be safe, and we'll win this fight against COVID-19.
Thank you so much, Dr. Shubham, for your 10 ka funda and cap. Very nicely said, knowledge, attitude, and practice. Nowadays, our WhatsApp university has given us so much of knowledge that actually we have to be wary of what all knowledge we are taking. So as Dr. Shubhank rightly said, we don't have to go into too much of knowledge that is floating. Sometimes it is too much of knowledge is also bad. We have to have the attitude that we will follow the rules properly and also practice hand hygiene and also how to cough and how to cook. So I come to Dr. Meenakshi. Dr. Meenakshi, someone was telling me some other acronym also that we have to follow. So can you tell us some more ways how to prevent?
All points have been described by Dr. Shubham very well. What are the major things to be done? But I'll just summarize everything in a very short form is we say SMS immunity. You know, there's something called as SMS immunity. So S is social distancing, M is the mask, S again is the sanitizing and hand washing together, immunity. So it's not just one thing we have to do, it's a combination of all which is important. So thinking that only social distancing will work or only mask will work, that is not the criteria. It is a combination of everything which leads to the prevention part. So all of them together will help you in preventing the coronavirus.
Very nicely put. SMS. Now we have SMS immunity.
SMS immunity.
Okay. So social distancing, masking. And someone was the other day saying the only difference that one is going to have in the era before corona and after corona is the mask. Everything is going to go on like it was. And now
we have to live with it.
Yeah, now we have to be there with masks and S, sanitizing. And Dr. Shubhank has very nicely explained in sanitization, it is the hand sanitization and also the fruits and vegetables and our grocery that we are getting, how that has to be sanitized, how our places are to be sanitized, all those things. Dr. Meenakshi, I would like to ask you about masks. There's too much of questions that are coming up about what kind of mask to wear and when to wear. Should I be wearing a mask while exercising or going for a jog and cycling? And if I'm going in a car with my family, should I be wearing a mask? So would you please tell us something about what's this about mask?
This is very, very important, and we have to first understand the importance of mask. As Dr. Shubham said, it's very important to understand that this is a respiratory infection. And you're not just preventing yourself from infection, you're preventing the others from getting the infection. So this is the main criteria that why we're wearing this, why one should wear a mask. Now in masks also, we have three different categories. I think many people ask me whether we should wear N95 or we should wear homemade masks or we should wear medical masks. So N95 is specifically left for the medical healthcare workers or the frontline workers who are with the COVID patients. We leave N95 for those people. Yes, the medical or the surgical mask, there are some, according to WHO, there are some people who should wear this medical masks. These are the people who are above 60. People who are having some kind of medical pre-existing diseases like diabetic, hypertension, all those people. And somebody who is under quarantine or isolation and the people who are looking after them. These are the people who have to wear medical masks. And then coming to the normal mask, which is the normal homemade mask or the cotton cloth mask, is to be worn by everybody. In general public, it is the simple mask which is to be worn by everyone. And now when you said, you asked another question about, yes, this is the one. Yes.
So this is a mask that my mom-in-law made from one of my cotton kurta that was just got torn from one place. So she made this mask like this.
It is very important. In fact, I have a mask here with me. So this is the medical mask. If you can see, this is how the mask looks like. This is the medical mask. And we know it's very important to understand when to replace a mask, how to wear a mask, especially the medical mask, as well as your homemade mask. So wearing a mask is important, how to wear it. First and foremost thing I would say is hand washing. because you, again, as Dr. Shubham said, this is a dangerous area. Don't touch it without doing a hand wash. So first and foremost step would be to wash your hands. Wash your hands, lift the mask, and then check whether there is any dampness or anything. It's stone, it's the ear plugs are loose. All these things need to be checked. And then it has to be without touching the front portion of the mask. It has to be immediately put it across the ears. It has to be put across the ears. Once, and removal is equally important. Once placed, the nose, mouth, and the chin have to be completely covered. This is very important. I've seen some people wearing only for the nose and the mouth. Exactly. The chin also needs to be fully covered.
Some people wear it like this.
Some people wear it like this. So it's these three portions need to be fully covered. Mm. Yes, exactly. So
we have to remember that mask is not a garland. It has to be it has to cover the nose.
All the three parts, nose, mouth, and chin. And no side leaks. It has to be fully secure. It has to be secure all around. So this is important. And while removal also, bend across. I've seen some people removing, touching the front part and just removing. Again, you're making your hands dirty. So removing, you just have to bend only the ear plugs, remove it and put it, dispose it. Disposal, again, that is a separate topic in itself, is a big thing. Disposal, if it is a homemade mask and needs to be disposed, immediately put it in a hot water for wash. But if it is a medical mask, it has to be disposed carefully. It has to be wrapped and put it for the biomedical waste. That can be done.
Dr. Meenakshi, the question that has been left unanswered is about whether I need to wear a mask when I go for a jog or an exercise.
Okay. Yes. This is very important. What happens when you go for a exercise, when you're doing strenuous exercise, there is a tendency for you to breathe more. The oxygen need is more. So what ideally one should avoid wearing a mask while doing strenuous exercises. I would say if somebody has to do strenuous exercises, should do at home. Avoid going out and doing strenuous exercises. It is not advisable to wear a mask when doing strenuous exercises. No, not at all. I would not advise people to wear mask while doing strenuous exercises. It has led to bad incidents. So I would advise people not to wear it. Another, this one thing, I've seen some ladies wrapping around dupattas and putting it as a mask. So that practice also, I would want to comment here. What happens normally is, they, even though it is creating a barrier, it is helping you to create a barrier, but what happens, you invariably, unnoticed, the, if you're putting it down, you don't know which part you're flipping it back. So it might happen the one part which was outside is coming back inside. So instead of protecting yourself, you're damaging yourself more. So that I would advise people avoid that practice of putting dupattas on the mouth.
Great. This is something that most of us have been doing. Ki aur kuch nahi to chalo dupatta laga le.
It is a barrier, no doubt.
But then if we are doing it with a gamcha, then we should know which part
which
is
side.
I'll say something here, ma'am. Sorry, but I am, yes, interesting. This is a Dr. Shubham. Dr. Shubham, you said that we need not to buy raw milk. So the question comes in our mind that even though we are taking the raw milk, but we are boiling it before using it. So doesn't boiling itself makes it infectious? Like, is it still infectious even after boiling?
Thank you for the question. So the what I mean to say is that if you boil any, raw milk properly, then less chances that there is some virus or bacteria in it. However, especially in, Delhi NCR population, we have seen there are various diseases like Brucella disease. Dr. Meenakshi must be aware of the, very common disease, and it spreads from the raw milk. Because usually in Haryana, if you will see, people have this tendency, they consume raw milk like that. And, they add in mango shake, they add in different, beverages they prepare at home. So then it becomes risky. I have also seen in the rural parts of India where they add raw milk directly in tea. And, the tea is boiled in a different kettle and directly the raw milk is poured in that and is consumed like that. So that can infect you. So the practice ideally should be using the pasteurized milk, which is very, very safe, at least at present time, because you don't know whether this infection is reaching the animals or, how they are protecting themselves, because unless and until a animal caregiver is giving them a bath or proper sanitization, animals can't protect themselves in that particular way. So we have to be very cautious about that, because I have seen many of my patients, especially from Gurugram, Haryana region, they have practice of consuming raw milk, which should not be continued, at least during COVID time. To be properly boiled, if you are using that, that's fine. And another addition to mask, which ma'am was asking, if you are going out in car, you need not to wear mask if you are alone. However, if there is some other person, there also you can practice social distancing. How? The person who is driving is on the front seat and you should sit on the back seat, you know, so that there is distance between your mouth and the driver's mouth. So 2 person in a car, okay. Otherwise 1 person in a car. But whole family going in one car, risky. Why you need a mask outside? Because you ideally don't need a mask. None of you are infected. But for example, if a policeman stops you or somebody there at the checking point, or you give money at the toll plaza, the person there not wearing mask, if he coughs, sneeze, or even while speaking, some droplets can come inside your car because you will put that window down or something like that. Then it's dangerous. So better to carry mask if you are stepping outside your house.
Very, very rightly said. So while if you are there in the car with family, so till the time it is all locked up, that doesn't make a difference. But yes, we all should be carrying our mask, because if we have to pull our windows down, etc., then masks should be on. Thank you so much, Dr. Shubham. And now, as the process of unlocking has started, and also the number of cases are rising like anything. I've stopped watching the news for the numbers, because rehna to hai hi yahan par, to kyun baar baar dekh ke apne aap ko pareshan kare. Phir bhi, as you said, we have to acquire knowledge so that our attitudes are right and we are practicing the right ways of protecting ourselves. So Dr. Shubham, what do you suggest about some kits, etc.? How do I prepare my house for this?
First of all, thank you for the question. Very important point you raised. The number is increasing. So, इससे दो interpretation है हर एक चीज की, कि glass आधा खाली है या आधा भरा है. हमारा देखने का उसके प्रति क्या attitude है? पहला कि भाई नंबर ज्यादा बढ़ रहे हैं, हमें लग रहा है क्या ये फेलियर है गवर्नमेंट का? नहीं, दिस इज अ स्ट्रेटजी. इट इज अ ग्लोबल स्ट्रेटजी डेवलप्ड बाय एन नंबर ऑफ इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस, दैट दिस स्ट्रेटजी इज T3. इट इज टेस्ट, ट्रैक एंड ट्रीट. ज्यादा से ज्यादा लोगों का टेस्ट करते जाओ, उनको कॉन्टेक्ट को ट्रैक करते जाओ एंड ट्रीट करते जाओ. सो वी आर वर्किंग ऑन T3 स्ट्रेटजी. यू टेस्ट मोर एंड मोर पीपल, नो प्रॉब्लम. इंडिया कुड बी ऑन सेकंड दिस थिंग लिस्ट or on the top, it hardly matters. We are a country of billion people, not million people. You know, we have many states who have more population than whole of the population of Europe. So we have to test more. In that comparison, if you see, our percentage of infected people is minimum. So we are testing more and more people. We have tested millions, but only few lakh are positive at present. Then track, we are tracking their contact history, whether they have met a car driver or their maid or anyone else in the family. We are testing them as well. And then treat. We have very effective treatment available. We have various, you know, medications right now available, because now it's not a new virus. The situation which was there in March for various other countries like United Kingdom or USA, it was very new for them. But now we have 10, 15 medicines which are kind of effective. I'm not saying all are 100% effective, but they are kind of effective and they are used in various clinical trials and people have very good results using it. So luckily in India, it has come later and we are prepared, well prepared in terms of our tertiary care hospital setting. If I'll talk about the ventilatory support and all, we have everything. Now, what you can prepare at your home, the emergency kit, which is very important right now, because we don't want you to rush to hospital unnecessarily. So what all you should have, obviously, you should have tablets like paracetamol at home. If somebody has fever, you can take it. If you have children at home, you can keep a syrup Calpol, you know, syrup paracetamol. You should have betadine solution with you. You should have clean cotton packs with you, some bandages with you. You should have, you know, some antibiotic, minor antibiotics. I will say usually we use erythromycin, we use amoxicillin, I'm not prescribing right now. That's not very scientific to do it during online session, but we usually keep these medicine with us. We keep ORS packets, you know, somebody having loose motions, that should always be kept. Medicines like Pantocid, you know, acidity, syrup, mucine, gel kind of antacid or Digene or Pudin Hara, whatever you like should be always available at your home. Eye drops like Refresh Tears or Tears Eye Drops, those should be available because if you have eye irritation, you don't really want to go to hospital right now or to a chemist. Just keep it in your house in a clean, sanitized area. What else? Dettol and Savlon solution should be there. You should have a BP apparatus if you have your old parents or grandparents at home. If any one of your parents is diabetic, then you should have a glucometer because the risk a diabetic has is of hypoglycemia, more than hyperglycemia. So aapko sugar unka check karna hai. You should always keep a box of candies and chocolates and, you know, sweeteners near them so that if they feel ke blood sugar is low, they can immediately take that because that's a step to save their life. If you have old grandparents, then you should have a wheelchair also at your home or maybe in your society compound, in your resident welfare association, at least one stretcher, one wheelchair, so that if you have to shift a patient after a casualty, I mean, because the maximum injury happens while transportation. People don't know how to transport them to the car or to ambulance and then ship to hospital. So they damage their neck, they damage their head and various other parts, even the spinal cord. So wheelchair and stretcher should always be available. So basic medicine, I said, also you can add vitamin C or any multivitamin which you like. That also like B cosus, people usually take Neurobion Fort or A2Z or Zincovit. You can keep all this stuff with you. I think this is more than enough. And if anyone has, you know, any minor ailment, so these medicines can always be kept. And we also run a free telemedicine. We have a team of 45 doctors, so we can share our contacts. Anyone wants to ask anything on WhatsApp, they can anytime message us. So this kit should always be prepared. Along with this, if you think you have a respiratory ailment, you can keep a pulse oximeter also. It's a saturation probe, which you can, you know, put on your finger to check the oxygen saturation level. So a normal person usually have above 94-95% or even 99% of, you know, oxygen saturation level, just to know that you don't have a respiratory problem, even if you have symptoms. So symptoms, what are the symptoms and who are the risk category people? I'll talk about in next 30 seconds. So again, my rule of 10, kaun log hain 10 jinko zyada dhyan rakhna hai? Ek hamare grandparents above 65-70, main manta hoon above 80 jo bhi hai unka bilkul dhyan rakhna hai. Then anyone has diabetes, hypertension, heart disease, kidney disease, liver disease, cancer patients, asthmatic patients, patient on immunocompromised therapy, patient who have recently been discharged from hospital after a surgery or major procedure. So these 10 category people are at higher risk of catching any infection, whether COVID or any other. So these 10 category people should always be protected. So hame dada dadi ke gale nahi lagna, unke pair nahi chhune is samay, wo bura nahi manenge, thoda distance maintain karna hai. Because it is very important. We are protecting them. Otherwise, hamare mein agar virus aaya, we are young people, we have strong immunity, we might fight. But those who have immunocompromised status, jinki immunity kam hai, unke liye it will be a big struggle. So we don't want them to land in emergency or in the ICU of the hospital. However, if I talk about the national statistics, to 90% patient jo corona ke hote hain, wo ghar pe theek ho jate hain. Ya thode se treatment ya guidance ke अंडर वो ठीक हो जाते हैं. इफ दे केयर प्रॉपरली, पानी अच्छे से पी रहे हैं, मेडिसिन टाइम पे ले रहे हैं, डाइट अच्छे से ले रहे हैं और मेंटल प्रेशर नहीं है, स्ट्रेस नहीं है, दे ऑल रिकवर. 10% टू 15% ऐसे होते हैं, दे हैव टू गो टू हॉस्पिटल बिकॉज दे हैव अदर कोमॉर्बिडिटीज एंड अदर प्रॉब्लम्स एज वेल. उसमें से हार्डली 5% ऐसे होते हैं, दोज हु रियली नीड ऑक्सीजन सपोर्ट और ICU केयर और 24/7 नर्सिंग सपोर्ट एंड अदर मेडिकेशन. एंड आउट ऑफ दैट 1% unfortunately can't make it, can't survive. So we have to reduce this percentage of 1% to minimum. If we are calling hospital on time, if we are reaching hospital on time and we are watchful, kya hame dekhna hai ki agar kisi ko fever aa raha hai, sore throat ho raha hai aur कॉफिंग हो रही है तो उसे अपने को सेल्फ आइसोलेट करना है अभी से, 7 दिन के लिए मिनिमम अपने रूम में हो जाएं, उतने जल्दी से जल्दी डॉक्टर को ऑनलाइन कंसल्ट कर रहे, यू नीड नॉट टू विजिट और विजिट अ हॉस्पिटल टू द फ्लू क्लिनिक, गेट योर सेल्फ टेस्टेड, आप टेस्ट करा लें, अगर आप नेगेटिव हैं नो प्रॉब्लम, आइसोलेशन कंटिन्यू रखें, कई बार नेगेटिव आ सकता है, अगर आप पॉजिटिव है देन यू रिपोर्ट टू द डिस्ट्रिक्ट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, 14 डेज कंप्लीट क्वारंटाइन शुड बी डन सो दैट यू डोंट इन्फेक्ट योर फैमिली मेंबर्स एंड पीपल इन कम्युनिटी, और इस दौरान इफ यू वॉच देर इज डिफिकल्टी इन ब्रीदिंग, सांस लेने में तकलीफ होती है, नाक के मुंह के पास कोई नीलापन आता है, बहुत बेहोशी सी छाती है, बहुत कमजोरी सी लगती है, नहीं उठ पा रहे और इतना ज्यादा फीवर है कि बिल्कुल भी रिस्पॉन्ड नहीं हो रहा पैरासिटामोल लेने के बाद, देन दिस इज अ काइंड ऑफ इमरजेंसी, यू शुड गो टू हॉस्पिटल, यू शुडंट अवॉइड बिकॉज देर आर सम गोल्डन मिनट्स एंड गोल्डन आवर्स, अगर जितना जल्दी आप पहुंच जाएंगे उतना जल्दी हॉस्पिटल्स में डॉक्टर्स आपको रिसिसिटेट कर सकते हैं, आपकी जान बचा सकते हैं, सो अर्ली डायग्नोसिस एंड प्रॉम्प्ट ट्रीटमेंट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, जल्दी से जल्दी हमें पता लगाना है, डिले नहीं करना कि हमें सोर थ्रोट हो रहा है, कॉफिंग हो रही है, फीवर, नहीं नहीं घर में ही बैठेंगे, नहीं, अर्ली डायग्नोसिस, जल्दी से पता लगाए, जल्दी से उसका ट्रीटमेंट करा दें, देन यू आर सेफ, ओके।
Thank you so much, Dr. Shubhank. You said early diagnosis and you also talked about teleconferencing with the doctors. That means we need not rush to the doctor to meet him or her physically. Initial stages, like you said, coughing or sore throat, etc. We can also talk to a doctor on phone. So from where to get this doctor on phone?
So we can provide our list of doctors and obviously, you know, hospitals like Medanta, you know, is a pioneer institution in the country. So they also have a telemedicine services. So somebody from our management side can discuss with you how we can tie up with all your students and their family members so that they have a, you know, a general telemedicine number of a hospital like Medanta or any other hospital you want to keep in your panel so that they can call and, you know, discuss with doctor on WhatsApp or just call a doctor or text a doctor, so that they can get an appointment early and, you know, they can relieve their anxiety, which happens even if it's not a real sore throat. They are so anxious that unhe lag raha hai ki mujhe corona ho gaya. So they really need to speak to a doctor. I think you have on panel very good doctor, Dr. Yeah. Meenakshi. Mm-hmm. So we can surely tie up, you know, in what ways, in what capacities Medanta Hospital can help you out, you know, making that kind of protocol.
Dr. Meenakshi, would you like to add anything to this? Doctor on call,
yes, I would say doctor on call is very much needed. In fact, we have already tied up with Medanta. I think this especially I would want to tell it for all the parents or students who are listening. We already have a tie up with Medanta, and if there are anything like queries like that, in fact we can form a helpline also. We can form a number kind of a thing in association with Medanta. Then that helpline number could be circulated among all the parents so that if any help is needed from Medanta or any other hospital, we can try and provide that.
So parents, no need to worry. Parents, family and friends, first of all. So have the knowledge and attitude that yes, we will win and get through this. And as Dr. Shubhank rightly said, mental stress nahi hona chahiye. Aadhi bimari to dimag se hoti hai. So dimag mein agar hum shant hain, that we have taken care of our immunities, our emergency kit, everything is ready and right at place, nothing will happen to us.
I think immunity is something we have to really stress on right now. All those SMS immunity, what I said, is something is the key right now. We have to stress so much on it because that is what is going to prevent you as much as possible.
Very rightly said. Dr. Shubhank also in the beginning talked about immunity. Now, Dr. Meenakshi, could you tell us a little more about this immune system and how to go take care of ourselves?
Immunity, as described by Dr. Shubhank, what happens is immunity, it's your how your body reacts to an infection. That is, it is the ability of your body to react to an infection. Either it can fail or it can pass, as simple as it is. If your immunity is good, you're able to prevent the infection, or in case if you catch the infection also, it is on the milder side, you recover faster. If the immunity is on the lower side or having some pre-existing conditions, diabetes, unme bhi immunity is on the lower side. So naturally, those are the people we always say are the ones who have some issues later on. they are not able to recover well or take little longer to recover. So immunity, it comprises of, there are many, many aspects to immunity. Diet is very important. Again, I would say five factors here. Diet plays an important role. Exercise, physical activity. Everybody knows physical activity is important, but how much we implement it, again, knowledge, attitude, practice comes here. Diet, physical activity, hydration, adequate water intake is very, very important. Sleep, which we always, nowadays what is happening, too many people watching online movies, sleeping late, no schools, nothing. So they sleep late, get up late. So whole circadian rhythm goes and hormonal disimbalance. So that also decreases your immunity. Sleep and stress. So all these, the combination of these five things will help us to build our immunity.
Pooja, ma'am, you wish.
Dr. Meenakshi, I'll just ask you something. I'm sorry, one of our viewers has asked that being with the doctor, definitely, you are a mother of two as well. So what exactly do you do so that the immunity of your children is boosted up? I mean, what basically in day-to-day life, maybe what Indian traditional, you know, techniques or spices, so what can be given to the children so as to boost up their immunity at home?
See, immunity, we have to understand, especially for children, it is, we say fruits, too many diet, if I go to diet first, we say have too many fruits, keep having fruits. It's not just fruits. It's not just fruits. It is a combination of many things together. Macronutrients and micronutrients, what we talk about. We always forget normal roti, dal, chawal is what we normally forget. That is very, very important. Protein intake has to be high. Protein, when I say, is the major component of building immunity. Protein intake has to be high, as well as your fruits, everything has to be there. Well, because that is how you get your minerals. Aapka zinc, especially prevention ki baat karte hain, toh what happens, your zinc, vitamin D and your vitamin C play a major role in prevention. So if you're having it adequate in your diet, you don't need to take supplements if you're having adequate diet. So vitamin C, again, I would say fruits ho gaya aapke, vitamin zinc ho gaya aapka, you would say dry fruits are very rich in zinc, whole grains are very rich in zinc. So all these things are about your diet. And then again, exercise, little bit of exercise is important. See, I will stress something here about lymphatic system. What happens about lymphatic system, if you don't know properly, not many people know about this lymphatic system. It is a network of lymphatic tissues and lymphatic organs in our body. It is spread throughout. So it is comprises of lymph nodes and lymphatic organs and everything. So they play a major role in immunity. What happens is that when there is circulation of lymph, we say immunity kisse aati? Immunity comes by lymphocytes. They are the white blood cells. White blood cells play the major role in immunity. So wo kaise circulate ho jata hai? It is circulated through the lymph. So I have a small video which I can just play on and show you the circulation, how lymphatic system works in our body. So if we can just play that short little video. That has the lymphatic system. I can just show you how it is beautifully explained. How, and people ask me how exercise is important, since you've asked this question, how exercise is important for immunity, because when you exercise, all these lymphatic system gets circulated in the body. Lymphatics, lymph gets circulated, which is circulating the, yes, I think we have a video. I will just show you this.
Till the video is going on, I do not know. Yes.
So, yes, this is how the lymphatic system, it is circulated throughout the body. And when you exercise, ye puri body mein circulate ho jata hai, lymph nodes. See, the infection is coming and yahan se hamara WBCs aate and then they fight. So you can see, these are the lymphatic organs. We have tonsils, thymus hai hamara, then spleen is there. This is the spleen, appendix. Bone marrow is also a lymphatic organ. So this is how the lymphatic system is in our body. It is preventing us our infection. And this slide is circulatory system or lymphatic system mein difference kya hai. This, many people ask, what is the difference between, not many people know lymphatic system kuch hota hai. So lymphatic system and circulatory system mein main ye difference hai. For circulatory system, we have a heart to pump in. So jab pumping hoti hai, to it is getting circulated in the body. But lymphatic system, system, which is important for the immune system, there is no pumping system. Pumping is only possible when you do some exercise. Physical activity aap karte ho, then it gets circulated in the body, hence producing immunity. So always, that is the reason people say physical activity karoge to aap immunity badaoge. This is how it happens. So the whole purpose of showing this video was to understand the importance of physical activity and building up immunity.
Dr. Shubham, people are asking, agar hame daant mein kuch problem hai, if there is some oral, I have to go to a dentist, so, and I'm not able to bear, so can I go right now these days? Is it?
So if they are taking all the precautions, now most of the dental clinic and dentists, you know, they are also very scientifically advanced. They are using PPE kits because the chances of aerosol infection is very high. So there are some dental emergencies. The dentist could be, you know, better in speaking about that, like severe pain, or you need a tooth extraction, or there is, you know, some bleeding. So then you have to visit a dentist. You can't avoid that. And in that time, obviously, they'll take all the precautions. They'll be wearing screen. They'll be, I mean, the face shields. They'll be having a PPE suit. And for your dental normal hygiene, you use maybe some chlorhexidine or Listerine mouthwash or just a betadine gargles. I mean, it's very effective. It's low cost. And you just take one glass of lukewarm water, add some betadine solution in this, and just gargle your throat. So by mistake, if virus is coming in your nasopharynx, that is your throat region, you gargle it and spit it out. And obviously, you are brushing your teeth twice a day. So you can visit dentist who is taking all the precautions.
Thank you so much. So Dr. Meenakshi was telling us very nicely about the lymphatic system that we have. We have lymph here around the ear area, the neck and all. So we have a yoga expert, Manju, here. And we also have student, a little yogi from our school. So we would request Manju, please tell us if the lymph nodes, as ma'am was explaining, are here near the ears, neck, and all through the body. So how to activate these lymph glands?
Good evening, everyone. Ma'am, lymphatic, jo hote humare throat side mein, aur jo pure respiratory system ke liye, jo pranayam hai, उसमें भी बहुत इफेक्टिव है अनुलोम विलोम प्राणायाम. वो हमारे रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम के लिए बहुत अच्छा है, जिसमें हम सबसे पहले करेंगे रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम के लिए अनुलोम विलोम प्राणायाम.
वेरी राइटली सर, बिकॉज अभी थोड़ी देर पहले डॉक्टर शुभांग ने बताया था कि 94% ऑक्सीजन कम से कम अगर ऑक्सीमीटर दिखाता है तो, एंड आई थिंक अनुलोम विलोम प्राणायाम अगर हम करते रहे तो हमारा ऑक्सीजन कॉन्टेंट ऑफ द बॉडी विल रिमेन हाई.
जैसे COVID-19 में इफेक्ट होता है हमारा रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम, उसके लिए भी बहुत अच्छा है. तो इसको हम करेंगे, राइट नोस्टल को क्लोज करेंगे, इंडेक्स फिंगर मिडल फिंगर क्लोज, राइट थंब टू राइट नोस्टल क्लोज, लिफ्ट टू इनहेल.
Manju ma'am, I'll just request you to please hold on. Can we request Vanshaj to put the video on mode so that we may see you?
Manju ma'am, tab tak aap bata dijiye. Maybe there is some problem with this video. Aap kariye.
Right hand se right thumb aapne upar uthana hai. Index finger, middle finger close. Right thumb to right nostril close. Lift to inhale. Other side exhale. Same side inhale. Then other side exhale. This is the alternate breathing. एक साइड से लेना है, दूसरे साइड से छोड़ना है, फिर सेम साइड से इनहेल करके अदर साइड एक्सेल करना है. ये हमारे ऑल्टरनेट ब्रीदिंग है जिससे हमारा रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम, जिसका ब्लड का फ्लो जो है उसको इजिली क्लियर करता है, और कहीं ब्लॉकेज हो ब्लड में उसको भी रिमूव करता है. बहुत इफेक्टिव है. इसके साथ एक और हम करते हैं कपाल भाती. ये एक शुद्धिकरण क्रिया है जो स्टमक एक्सरसाइज है. इसमें हम एयर फिल करते हैं स्टमक में, ऑटोमेटिकली इनहेल अपना होता है और एक्सहेल होता है फोर्सफुली. लुक एट मी. जो स्टमक है वो फोर्सफुली आपका एक्सहेल होगा, इनहेल आपका ऑटोमेटिकली होगा। इसका आप कैपेसिटी के अकॉर्डिंग 20-30 राउंड्स कर सकते हैं, धीरे धीरे आप इसको बढ़ा सकते हैं। ये शुद्धिकरण क्रिया के लिए भी बहुत अच्छा है और रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम के लिए भी अच्छा है, इंडाइजेशन के लिए भी बहुत अच्छा है। एक होता है अग्निसार क्रिया, ये भी हीटिंग है, ये भी एक क्रिया है। इसमें हम वज्रासन में बैठते हैं। वंशज इज देयर?
यस ही इज देयर।
ओके वंशज, सिट डाउन, वज्रासन। यस, दोनों लेग्स को फोल्ड करना है।
ठीक है,
दोनों लेग्स को फोल्ड करके दोनों हैंड्स को थाइज के ऊपर रखना है, वज्रासन। वज्रासन, बैक स्ट्रेट, डीप इनहेल, डीप एक्सहेल। स्टार्टिंग में आपने डीप ब्रीदिंग करनी है, ब्रीद इन देन ब्रीद आउट। जब नॉर्मल ब्रीदिंग हो जाए उसके बाद आपने ब्रीद आउट करने के बाद फास्ट फास्ट आपने स्टमक की मूवमेंट्स करनी है। एक बार करके दिखाइए वंशज, फास्ट फास्ट। एक्सहेल आउट करने के बाद फिर आपने स्टमक पे फास्ट फास्ट इनसाइड आउटसाइड अग्निसार क्रिया।
सो मंजू मैम, ये तो हो गए ऑक्सीजन कंटेंट और साथ में यहाँ हमारे इधर स्टमक और यहाँ के लिम्फ सिस्टम्स को एक्टिवेट करने का। अब अगर जो मेरे जैसे डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी ने बोला कि हमारे स्पाइन में भी हैं लिम्फ ग्लैंड्स और हमारे जो काफ मसल्स हैं वहां पर भी लिम्फ ग्लैंड्स हैं, वहां तक के हमें पंप्स को एक्टिवेट करना है, तो उसके लिए क्या एक्टिविटीज होंगी?
हाँ जी मैम, उसके लिए भी एक्सरसाइज है, जैसे हम स्टैंडिंग में कर सकते हैं ताड़ासन। कुछ हमारे जो लिम्फ ग्लैंड है वो हमारे थाइज में भी होते हैं, थाइज के नीचे ये जो हमारा होता है पैरों के ऊपर, एंकल के ऊपर, उसको एक्टिव करने के लिए क्या करते हैं हम, हील्स को ऊपर उठाते हैं। हील्स, आप
खड़े हो जाइए
वंशज,
ताड़ासन।
ताड़ासन से पहले हम करेंगे पैरों को आगे से उठाना है, पंजों को, फिर पीछे से हील्स को। पहले हम ये अप डाउन भी कर सकते हैं, उसके बाद धीरे धीरे बॉडी को स्ट्रेच करके ताड़ासन। हील्स आप, ये देख रहे हैं आप, अपर बॉडी स्ट्रेच एंड हील्स आप, इसमें पूरी बॉडी स्ट्रेच हो रही है।
इनफैक्ट सारा ही लिम्फेटिक सिस्टम एक्टिवेट हो रहा है,
ऑल बॉडी के लिए है। वेरी गुड, कम बैक। इसके अलावा हम कर सकते हैं सिट डाउन, कैमल पोज। ये सिटिंग आसन है, कैमल पोज। स्टैंड ऑन नी, नी के ऊपर खड़े होकर धीरे धीरे एक्सहेल करके हमने हाथों को पीछे की ओर लेकर जाना है। स्टार्टिंग में जो कर रहे हैं वो बैक को हाथ पर रख सकते हैं, बैक के ऊपर भी रख सकते हैं। जो बहुत ज्यादा अच्छे से कर सकते हैं वो हैंड्स को हील्स के ऊपर भी लेके जा सकते हैं। जैसे आप देख रहे हैं ये हील्स के ऊपर रखा है, बैक के लिए भी अच्छा है और जो हमारे लिम्स हैं उसको भी एक्टिवेट करता है। कम बैक, यही पोजीशन वंशज, एक बार हाफ कैमल पोज करके दिखाइए, हैंड्स ऑन द बैक, एक्सहेल चाओ, धीरे धीरे नेक को आपने पीछे लेके जाना है। बहुत ही इफेक्टिव है ये, बहुत सारी चीजों में इफेक्टिव है, सर्वाइकल के लिए, थायराइड के लिए, और ये स्पाइकल जो आपके शोल्डर, फ्रोजन शोल्डर के लिए भी अच्छा है, बैक फ्लेक्सिबल करता है।
मुझे लगता है जो हमारे शोल्डर और नेक रीजन के जो लिम्फ ग्लैंड्स हैं वो भी एक्टिवेट,
वो भी एक्टिव। यस यस मैम, कम बैक। इसके बाद हम एक मंडूक आसन कर सकते हैं, वो डायबिटिक पेशेंट के लिए भी अच्छा है। जैसे डायबिटिक पेशेंट के लिए मंडूक आसन, दोनों हैंड्स को ग्रिप करके स्टमक के ऊपर रखना है, देन धीरे धीरे एक्सहेल आउट, फॉरवर्ड बेंडिंग, फोरहेड फ्लोर पे टच करना है, मंडूक आसन। डायबिटिक पेशेंट के लिए भी बहुत अच्छा आसन है,
वेरी इजी आसनास व्हिच एनीवन कैन डू।
स्लोली स्लोली कम बैक। एक और आसन है,
हाँ हम एक छोटा सा प्रोटोकॉल, खाली कोरोना सेवियर प्रोटोकॉल बना लेते हैं इस तरह में बात करते समय। तो सबसे पहले हमने प्राणायाम करें, जिससे हमारा ऑक्सीजन कंटेंट बढ़ा. फिर हमने अपनी लिम्फेटिक सिस्टम को बढ़ाने के लिए आपने एक हमें ये कैमल पोज बताया, ठीक है, एक ताड़ासन, बहुत ही आसान हमारी एक्टिविटीज हैं जो एनीवन वेदर जितना भी उनकी फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी कम भी हो वो भी उसको एक्टिवेट कर सकते हैं. तो इसी तरह से और कुछ और
ट्विस्टिंग,
तीन दो तीन बता दें ताकि लोग डेली रूटीन में करें तो दैट वुड बी बेटर.
ट्विस्टिंग पोज, वक्रासन, दोनों लेग्स को सामने की तरफ खोल लीजिए, राइट लेग आगे, लेफ्ट को बेंड कीजिए, जो लेग आपकी बेंड है वही हाथ आपका पीछे जाएगा, और अदर साइड से ट्विस्ट करके एंकल को या आप टो को पकड़ सकते हो. अगर आप नहीं पकड़ पा रहे हैं तो जो भी आप इजीली पकड़ सके, अपनी थाई को पकड़ लीजिए, नीचे से थाई को भी पकड़ सकते हैं जो इजीली नहीं कर पा रहे, एंकल भी कर सकते हैं, जितना आप कंफर्टेबल जोन में कर सकें. और ये आसन आपने एक साइड से दूसरी साइड भी करना है बॉडी की फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी के लिए. इसके अलावा हम लेइंग पोजीशन में भी कर सकते हैं. कम बैक वंशज, वापस आ जाइए. कोबरा पोज, भुजंग आसन, दोनों हाथों को चेस्ट के साइड पे रखना है, दोनों लेग्स को ज्वाइंट करना है, धीरे धीरे हेड को ऊपर की ओर लेकर जाना है. ये भी बहुत इफेक्टिव है. ये आपके देखिए यहाँ पे जो थायराइड इन्फेक्शन होती है, जैसे ये आपका सर्वाइकल वाला एरिया है ये कवर कर रहा है, बैकएक की प्रॉब्लम, फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी के लिए अच्छा है, थायराइड के लिए भी अच्छा है.
थैंक यू सो मच. आई थिंक दीज मेनी आर एनफ बिकॉज इसमें हमने पूरी बॉडी कवर कर ली है. फॉर द अभी हमारा मेन जो था कि अपने इम्यून सिस्टम को, लिम्फेटिक ग्लैंड्स को एक्टिवेट करने के लिए हमें क्या क्या एक्टिविटीज करनी चाहिए, तो आई थिंक दोज ऑल आर कवर्ड. सो इसमें एक और चीज जो मैं ऐड करना चाहूंगी वो ये कि डेली इतना तो हम करें कि अपने कानों के आगे पीछे मालिश करें और कानों को पुल करें तो अपने कान के आसपास के जो हमारे लिम्फ नोड्स हैं वो एक्टिवेटेड रहें. तो ये छोटी छोटी चीजें हैं जो यहाँ कान के और गले के आसपास उसको हम और कान को पुल करें. जो पुराने जमाने में हम कहते थे कि टीचर सजा दे रही है, वो सजा नहीं है, वो एक्चुअली आपके इम्यूनिटी को स्ट्रॉन्ग करने
के लिए. ब्रेन सर्कुलेशन,
हाँ, ब्रेन सर्कुलेशन ना, ब्रेन जिम में द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ माय स्कूल दे नो दैट. माय सेल्फ एज प्रिंसिपल, हम जब मॉर्निंग असेंबली में मिलते हैं शुभांग सर, तो वी आई along with the students we do brain gym where we cross our hands and do uthak baithak with this so that everyone knows ki ye thing saza nahi hai.
Oxford University proved it that it is the very healthy exercise to increase circulation in your brain.
Yes,
immediately.
So all those parents who are listening to us, please see to it that ye jo hai na apna uthak baith kaan pakad ke uthak baithak जो पहले बचपन में सजा मानी जाती थी, तो उसको आप
लिम्फेटिक सिस्टम, व्हेन यू बेंड, व्हेन यू सिट डाउन एंड यू गेट अप अगेन, योर काफ मसल्स गेट कंप्रेस, वो पंप करता है, इट सेंड्स द लिम्फेटिक्स अप.
तो सो आसनों का एक आसन है कान पकड़ के मुर्ग उठक बैठक. दो आसनों का एक आसन, कान पकड़ के उठक बैठक. तो प्लीज पेरेंट्स, प्लीज डू इट, दिस डू दिस आसना विद योर किड्स एंड यू ऑल्सो डू इट सो दैट योर इम्यून सिस्टम इज एक्टिवेटेड एंड द लिम्फ ग्लैंड्स आर एक्टिवेटेड. सो एनी अदर क्वेश्चन दैट्स कमिंग अप फ्रॉम द फेसबुक मैम?
Yes, ma'am. We have so many questions actually. Yes, and we are going to request the doctors for if some questions are left unanswered, we'll request the doctors to please just write down their answers in the viewers box. Right now, I'm asking a few because many parents wish to ask: can we give supplements like vitamin D supplement or C supplement or zinc to children, or should we give or not?
Yes, Dr. Shubham.
So we have certain vitamins which are water soluble. That is B and C. Even if you give it excess, okay, it will be eliminated from the body. However, there are certain which are fat soluble, A, D, E, K. So the vitamin A, if you are giving excess, it is causing hypervitaminosis A. If you are giving vitamin D excess, it is causing vitamin D toxicity. So you can't give excess of it. However, if it is recommended by a doctor and your levels of vitamin D in your body is low, you can take But you know, a normal A to Z capsule kind of stuff, or a NeuroBion, or a normal multivitamin, which usually your pediatrician advises you, you know, for your child. So that can be given during this time. Vitamin C chewable can be taken, or the natural source Dr. Meenakshi has already emphasized on taking citrus fruits or lemon water every day, or you can prepare kadha. You know, the Ayush Mantralaya's prescription of kadha. So you add your citrus fruits in your diet. So that is more than enough to give you the recommended dose of vitamin C. So all this should be given in a recommended dose. Excess of few fat-soluble vitamins is dangerous for your body. So don't give it.
It means in the very simple language, I should say that the food is given in a proper quantity. And if daily we are giving the basic requirement of our body, there's no requirement for to be given any supplement to our children. It's better to give them something natural.
और आजकल धूप है, बच्चे थोड़ी देर थोड़ा सा धूप भी ले लें तो विटामिन डी अपने
विटामिन डी विल बी सफिशिएंट
इज आल्सो दे कैन सिट इन द बालकनीज फॉर सम टाइम एंड हैव सम बिकॉज़ चिल्ड्रन आर नॉट गोइंग डाउन दे कैन सिट इन द बालकनीज एंड हैव सम विटामिन डी इन द मॉर्निंग आवर्स 11 टू 10 11 बजे के करीब दे कैन सिट इन द सन एंड हैव सम
One question comes to me as because you are coughing like this. So some of the droplets will stay on my clothing, isn't it? So isn't that also so then how much is the spread of the virus through clothing or
for example, like it happens with me when I'm talking for long or sitting in one posture. It's a kind of reflex. Yes. So at least I am not contaminating my hand. Second, my clothes will be washed every day. So there are very less chances that, you know, anybody will be touching this part of my elbow. Nobody touches, you know. So at least, and this part is never touched. And my doors are not touched in that way. The tabs are not touched in that way. Cupboards are not touched in that way. So no fomite is touched. So we are just preventing. However, this is also not very scientific. Best is to keep the disposable tissue papers or your own handkerchief. But sometimes that's not possible. So I am repeatedly trying to do during this video.
Yeah, I could see that.
This is the way to sneeze
you
or cough.
That.
Right. It shouldn't be like that. And it shouldn't be in your hand. Because if you are doing it in your hand, wash it.
Dr. Meenakshi, one more question. Because you told very particularly which areas of our face should be covered when we put a mask. So the question says that is it important to cover our hair also when we go out? Or if we have not covered our hair properly, should we wash them every time we get back from work or get back from market maybe? So whenever we are getting back home, should we wash our hair?
So I'll explain it a bit. For this, people need to understand and researchers keep coming every day now. Every day the researchers are changing. Earlier it was said, yes, there is a surface contact. It remains there. The virus remains there for some time and all. But now the research is saying that it does not stay there for the surface contact. Is not surface contact transmission is on the lower side. But still, I would say, if somebody is going to outside just for some little time and coming back, need not wash their head and everything. But somebody is going to a crowded area where there is the number of people are more in a mass gathering or going for a longer duration. Yes, definitely, I would advise them to have a wash.
Okay, thank you so much for putting light on all these areas. So over to you, ma'am, principal ma'am.
So can we end this or can it go because it is already 6:05? The time for the webinar is over. So if there
you have more interesting questions, we can answer. Right.
We have one question which says, what are the stress boosting exercises? Because COVID is definitely, it's like introduced to our health as well. But yes, it is stressing more over our minds. So this question may be there for Manju ma'am as well. Some meditation techniques. So can we say that these simple breathing exercises are also the meditation techniques?
Yes, ma'am. Breathing exercise, deep breathing. डीप इनहेल डीप एक्सहेल जब हम गहरी लंबी सांस लेते हैं तो सब ध्यान हमारा हटके हमारा ब्रीदिंग के ऊपर जाता है जो फर्स्ट टेक्निक है हमारी ब्रीदिंग की वो मेडिटेशन के लिए बहुत जरूरी है या आप बैठ के कर रहे हैं या योग निद्रा लेट के कर रहे हैं बट जब आपका ध्यान नहीं होगा कभी भी अगर आप मेडिटेशन करने बैठेंगे तो आपका ध्यान नहीं लगेगा आपको ध्यान लगाने के लिए ब्रीदिंग के ऊपर कॉन्सेंट्रेट करना पड़ेगा डीप ब्रीदिंग वो बहुत अच्छी चीज है.
ऐसे कहते हैं ना, जब गुस्सा आया है या कोई एकदम एंग्जाइटी है तो सबसे पहले गहरी सांस लो. टेक अ डीप ब्रेथ.
So deep breath actually relieves you. I've personally tried this many times. When you actually take a deep breath, you feel very relaxed. Automatic, it comes to you naturally sometimes. When you're tired, you automatically, it is a natural action of your body. You start doing deep breathing.
And another thing is, Pooja, I would like to say, ki stress ab kis baat ka hai? Doctor bhi keh rahe hain, khali cap lagao. That is knowledge, attitude of practice. Theek hai?
Aur I rather ask Shubham.
Then everything is fine, isn't it?
True. Dr. Shubham, just tell me, as
you need not worry.
As ma'am told, we need not to worry and we need not to have stress of any sort. But I'm just asking you, like, does it really happen that when you are stressed, your immune system also is disturbed and it gets weakened? Yes. I wish you to throw some light on that, so that all know that we need to remain happy so as to boost up our immune system. It's not only food and having good diet or something. It's all about your happiness mental health as well.
Happiness is very important in the present time. You know, you are watching news, you're listening to negative stories, somebody in your neighborhood is positive, you are so anxious. So what happens during anxiety? There is fear hormone secreted, you know, adrenaline is secreted. So that should not be secreted. You should not have that fear. What you really need is happy hour hormone. What is happy hour hormone? These are endorphins. These are good hormones. So if you are happy, if you are not stressed, if you are rejuvenating, if you are meditating, then no disease can touch you. Even if that virus comes, your own immune system is so strong. So I'll talk about a very simple exercise, which I tried and I even passed it in the family members as well. Right now, maids can't come. You know, there are restrictions. So the best exercise, you go and wash utensils. If you go and wash utensils, especially kids, you know, they are so tired whole day doing online sessions, their tuitions, the project work and everything. I have observed in, you know, in my family as well. So I told them, what you can do in evening time, go wash utensils, help your mother, help your parents to do something, watering of plants, you know, some dusting, etc. you could do at home. And washing of utensils is a very good exercise, I feel, because you have hand movements, your concentration.
That has come to all the, you know, all the family members itself now. So this is a good, you know, give up of corona.
Yeah. So they feel happy because you are participating. There is effective engagement. They feel happy. You are appreciating their whole day stress, because I know you all as moms are doing a lot of job every day, you know, to keep family healthy, to keep yourself healthy, as well as there is a lot of work. And when you do these kind of exercise, for example, washing a utensil, I was reading an article by a, you know, some researcher in US. He was saying that he was very much stressed and depressed, and he used to have very negative thoughts of suicide or, you know, harming anyone. But what he observed, that his wife is always happy. She comes back from her job and her only attention is, today 5 plates will be used, 5 bowls will be used, and I have to wash that, finish it off. So your body needs some task which you finish it off. You don't want to keep it pending. During COVID time, everything is pending. When it will end, then we will live, then we will go out, you know, that kind of anxiety. So every day, finish it off. Watering of plant, mopping floors, or just wash utensils. You will feel very happy. You have finished the task. There is no feeling of worthlessness.
Giving ourselves smaller tasks and that feeling of completion.
Right.
Actually, so
very important. Yes.
Very nicely said, Dr. Shubhank and Pooja. Accomplishment. So I would just add this. This brings me to, I was reading an article about the happiness hormones. Dr. Shubhank said one of the happiness hormone being endorphins, and endorphins get secreted when we exercise. So there, झाड़ू पोछा लगाइए घर में या exercise करो. अभी मंजू मैम ने कुछ exercises बताई हैं, and laugh aloud. So उसमें आपके endorphins बढ़ेंगे. Then dopamine is another happiness hormone, and it gets secreted when we accomplish our tasks. तो थोड़े 5 बर्तन धो के घर से चमका दिया, तो वो जो अकम्प्लिशमेंट है ना कि देखो हमने कितना काम करा है, तो दैट विल ऑल्सो गिव यू हैप्पीनेस हार्मोन. सो दैट इज अनदर हैप्पीनेस. सो पेरेंट्स, फ्रेंड्स एंड टीचर्स, हूएवर इज वॉचिंग अस, प्लीज रिमेंबर इनक्रीज योर हैप्पीनेस क्वोशेंट, बिकॉज दैट इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर इंक्रीजिंग द इम्यूनिटी. Increase your endorphins by exercising. Increase your dopamine by accomplishing small tasks. There is another happiness hormone that is serotonin. थोड़ा सा मैंने कहीं पढ़ा था इसलिए I can just add all this. Serotonin they said increases is a joy of giving. When we give something to someone, that is also increases our happiness quotient. So sharing and the joy of giving, making new things, that will increase our serotonin. And the last one is oxytocin. That is also a happiness hormone. And that comes from that Munna Bhai MBBS ka jadu ki jappi. Aajkal abhi Dr. Shubhang ne keh diya, jappi toh dalni nahi hai. Aur toh kya karna hai? You can do it to yourself. Yes, I have done it good. And share it. And you can... say a pat on the back, yes, you are getting it. And those emotions are to be there, I think. So I think we had a nice session. Thank you so much. Okay, do we have
just any? At last,
yes,
what ma'am said, one last exercise I will request all the young scientists. And this was exercise which was taught to me by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, sir. When you wake up early in the morning, always say, I am fit, I am healthy. Tap yourself. I am fit. I am healthy. I request everyone to do this during this live session. अच्छे से बोलना है जोर से. Yes, ma'am. Yes. आपको भी. I am fit. आप बोलेंगे I am healthy. I am fit. I am healthy. I am fit. I am healthy. Yes.
Thank you so much. It really had been so invigorating and, you know, energetic a session. And just keeping in view that positivity is increased around, we need not to get scared of COVID. I mean, we are safe, we are hale, we are healthy and nicely living with our family. You know, I mean, getting all the accomplishments, the daily accomplishments and increasing our happy hormones. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. So we come to an end, though the session, we feel we should keep talking like this. So now coming to the end, on the behalf of Team DAV Sector 49 Gurugram and all viewers, I extend a very hearty vote of thanks to the two speakers, especially Dr. Shubhank, who has come to us, and such a vibrant doctor who wishes to connect everyone. And your vibrance is also you say contagious. So I would like to take that virus from you, that vibrance. And as he said, he has been an awardee, and he has been awarded by Dr. Abdul Kalam himself. And such a thing that oxytocin ke liye hum apne aap ko hi pat karenge to bahut acha baat hai. Thank you so much, Dr. Shubhank, for gracing this and sharing with us your findings and your facts, your cap and the SMS. I would like to express my thanks to Dr. Meenakshi, our own doctor, and so beautifully, doctor, you have explained to us about the lymphatic system and how to see to it, what are the various places. And yes, we will remember your SMS that sanitize, mask and social distancing with increase of immunity. Manju, thank you so much. You have, with the very simple activities, you have told us how to go about, and the team, Manju ma'am and Vanshaj together, have helped us know how simple activities can be done to boost up in immunity. And during this session, yes, the happiness hormones that just came across, I think we all are going to enjoy. And I cannot thank every one of our viewers enough for the involvement and their willingness to take on the session beyond their comfort zones. Obviously, it's Sunday and 5 to 6 we are doing it, but I'm sure for you, this session has been great learning and reliever of a mental stress. Sab stress buster ho gaya hoga, I'm sure, because it has been for me. Mere to dopamine bhi badh gaya na, sense of accomplishment bhi aa gaya. So thank you so much. And I have to thank from the bottom of my heart, my core of my heart, the team IT of my department, of my school, kitna dil se, lagan se, the way they have collaborated and brought this session live on Facebook for all of us. Thank you so much. And thank you, Pooja ma'am, for coordinating the whole thing and seeing what is happening at the Facebook and the questions. Thank you.
Thanks, everyone.
Stay healthy till we meet physically. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank